of everlasting joy. You are the river of eternal peace. Those who were drawn near will be satisfied. Your life is given to all who drink. You made me like a tree planted by waters, drinking of your favor, drinking of your life. You made me like the dawn, shining ever brighter, living in your glory, living in your light. Yeah. Eternal peace. Those who will draw near will be satisfied. Your life is given to all who drink. You made me like a tree planted by your waters, drinking of your favor, drinking of your life.
My debt is paid, my guilt is gone. Because of grace, my heart is free. I live because of mercy. Should I in weakness sin again, I'll never have to bear the shame. My God, my Savior died for me. I live because of mercy. Your great mercy has lifted me up from shame. Your great mercy has broken my every chain. Your great mercy has flooded my soul with peace. Your great mercy has rescued.
Hi everyone, from all the team at Grace Vineyard Church, we want to say
Merry Christmas!
Yay!
So
Kia ora te whanau, welcome to Grace at Your Place, and today it's Christmas Day.
Special
and
day.
Yeah, we've got a whole lot of guests that are coming in soon. We've got our boy Ben here, who's our kids pastor at Grace, and this is the very special gift that we got during the year, which has made our year so wonderful. This is little Thea Grace. Ben's little daughter, what's it made Christmas like for you, Ben?
Mere kere he me te kia koutou. Merry Christmas, everyone. This has been the best gift ever because I've got to see what Jesus came as for the first Christmas day as a little baby. And do you know, it's pretty crazy just knowing that Jesus came as a baby, that God who made the whole universe came as a human being and as a little baby. And the beautiful gift was when Thea was born, I got an insight into the first words that Jesus ever said. Do you know what they were?
What was that?
She's looking worried.
Yeah, I'm speaking babish today. But it's just a reminder that actually God decided to come into a human body and as a baby, and he understands what we're going through, and he's came to be one of us.
One of the things about babies too, I always feel, is that they're just so vulnerable and so dependent on us to care for them and love them. And that's how God came into our lives, as someone vulnerable and trying to embrace our humanity, really.
Isn't it incredible that the God that created everything, the large, huge God, squished himself down into a tiny little baby form to come and to be with us. And Lizzie's just going to read from Luke chapter 2, just talking about the announcement of what actually happened when Jesus came.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, watching over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you." She's agreeing.
She's saying it as well. Amen.
"He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
You can imagine just how precious that little gift was when Jesus first arrived to Mary and Joseph. But it wasn't just a gift for Mary and Joseph, it was a gift for the whole world. And, you know, one of the things we think about this Christmas is why Jesus was sent. And Jesus was sent because we were lost. And we're so precious to God. And I've told the story a lot of times, but I'll tell it again. When this little fella here was young, when he was about 3 or 4 years old, we went to the Palms Mall, and we're wandering around with our other boy, Simon, and suddenly I said, "Honey, have you got Ben?" And she said, "No, I thought you had Ben." And we looked at each other, and Ben was lost. And the panic that went up in my heart.
It was terrible.
Oh my goodness, you know, your kids are so precious. And we went on this big search, and we were trying to get people to help us look, and he just disappeared. And just the panic. And finally we found him. He was doing what he does most, eating lollies, sitting on the desk at Kmart, being looked after by the customer services person. And he was safe and well, and as you can see, has thrived ever since.
That's right, especially with the lollies.
But, you know, I always think about that, you know, when someone is missing, a mum and a dad are just beside themselves. And the Bible tells us that we were missing once, and so God sent out a search party, and Jesus was part of that search party, coming to look for us, first of all to tell us how precious we are, but secondly to save us by dying on the cross. And so at Christmas time, it's the beginning of the Christmas story. It's telling us that we're incredibly precious to God, that we are so precious that he came down in human form to tell us that he loves us, to die in our place on the cross, to save us from our sin, and just to show that we are precious, that we can live with him forever. What does Christmas mean to you, honey?
Well, for me, it is about remembering how God came into our humanity and in our frailty and in our weakness. And that to me is the crux of the message, really, that he knows us, that he knows how we're wired, he knows our humanity. So the love that he has for us is from that place of knowing how we are formed and how he made us.
Any other thoughts about Christmas?
And chocolate.
Oh, chocolate. Yeah. That's a chocolate of fun. Yeah. I think for me, I've realised this year that God doesn't want to just meet our expectations. He actually wants to exceed our expectations. That God is so good with the unexpected. And especially with a year like this year where it's been so unexpected.
Crazy. Wow.
And
yeah.
There's been crazy things that actually the wise men, they search for the star in the darkest of night.
Yeah.
And it's funny that stars only shine at nighttime. And so they were traveling at night, they think around 2 years, and the stars shine bright in the darkest of night.
Yeah.
And so I feel like God just saying that his hope is still here to be found in the darkest of times, and that he is still the gift that keeps giving.
That's
and
so beautiful.
He doesn't just want to meet us in our expectations, but he actually wants to go beyond our expectations as well.
I love
so
that.
Good.
That's a good word, Ben.
It's so good because it has been dark around our world and even around our country, and people's fears have grown and anxieties have grown. But at Christmas time, we realise that there is massive hope. And when you look at this gorgeous little Thea and how beautiful she is and how precious she is, that's a reminder of the gift that God gives to us. Now, before she packs up...
Makes us emotional, doesn't it?
We're going to have a little look at the Christmas story.
And they voted me in out, and I wasn't even an imposter. My mum's gonna get a new iPhone, and I'm gonna play Among Us on it. But Dad said Santa is on a tight budget.
Well, I want a horse for Christmas. That would be the best gift.
That's not the best present. It's the grey-handled green kyber saber.
My mum told me about the bestest gift ever.
A face mask?
Nah, bro, even better. It started 2,000 years ago.
In a galaxy far, far away.
Bro, let me tell the story.
Kids these days. It was in a little sleepy town when a little lady was cleaning her house. Suddenly, an angel appeared. He said to her, "Greetings, the Lord is with you." She said, "What do you want, sir?" The angel said, "Don't worry, Mary. God wants to bless you with a baby. He will be the Son of God. He will be the King of everything. He will. Oh, he will. She went to tell Queen Elizabeth. I mean her cousin Elizabeth. Her cousin Lizzie was very pregnant as well.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for giving me a baby. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The empty one has noticed me.
Went to tell Joseph, that's her boyfriend, and Joseph took it pretty well, but Joseph was confused.
But why was
Joseph confused?
I don't know. Dad said something about birds and bees.
No.
Oh, I love birds and bees.
Me too, but Joseph didn't. And the angel came to calm Joseph down. Don't worry, Joseph, or Saint Harry. Don't be afraid to marry Mary. Don't worry. Get it? Mary, Mary, be happy. Joseph took Mary on a donkey. They went to his hometown Bethlehem. Although this was a special baby, no one had room for him in his home. In a stable, he had a baby. Mary was in a stable condition, and they called the baby Jesus. He was going to be the King of Kings to save the world. The hotel owner was so excited, he came and started to sing to him.
Outside the inn in Bethlehem, the King is born tonight. In a stable, born.
Joseph said to Jesus, Jesus, I am your father.
And everybody came to see the baby. Even some wise men came to give him some gifts. They were pretty loaded.
Shepherds came. Angels had just come and sung to them. It was crazy.
All the shine of a thousand spotlights. Angel swarms are filling the night sky. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Peace on earth to all God favors. The hands that form the world are held here.
A bit sheepish. They all came to see this baby. It would have been stinky in the stable. Baby Jesus probably pooed.
What is wrong with this one?
He was the most wonderfulest, craziest, and the bestest gift the world has ever seen. He came to show everyone there's a God who loves them. He can save us from all of the wrong things we've done. And he came on that first Christmas day.
Do you remember the 25th night of December? Love came down to the earth in a manger. Lying on a bed of hay. Our hearts were ringing.
Get up at 5 a.m. this morning, Dad.
Yeah, we know.
Hey, Georgie, present for you.
Huh?
So can you open it up? What is it? Rip it open. Keep the thing
Oh,
it's a face mask. Just what you always wanted.
Okay, Ted, this last present's for you.
Oh my God, it's the box of the grey-handled green Kyber-Sova. This is the second Mrs. Gift ever.
Well, one of the best parts of Christmas is being together with family. Yeah. We've got our boy Ben and little Thea. Oh, all the rest it's of our family's man. Here. Come on in, everyone. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Come and see us. Hey, here we go. Oh, do you want to come and see Papa? Oh, this is Honey. Honey May. Oh, and there's some balloons. Look. So this is our family, some of our wider family. Ben and... Oh, my goodness. What's your name? His name is Marley. And this is Honey May. Boo! Oh, my goodness. Oh, this is too much of a surprise at Christmas time.
Yeah, for an old man.
And this is Honey.
This is Honey May. Simon and Charlotte. Simon and Charlotte are the parents of this one and this one. And we've got Anna. Anna is 19 years old. She's my PA.
Oh,
and over in the United States, we've got... We've got Josh and Eva, and Ben's wife is called Anna. And this is very quickly turning to chaos. But anyway, from our family to your family, yeah. Merry Christmas! Yay. See you guys! Yay. Lovely Bye. To see you!
I'll
Bye!
I keep Honey.
Oh. Oh.
I got it.
Ah, there we go. Oh, that was fun.
Isn't it beautiful?
Fun when they arrive and fun when they go. No, 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 that's not right. That's our fam.
Isn't it lovely having our family all together?
Oh, that's the lovely thing about Christmas, isn't it? We are feeling for those people who don't have family around them, though. Our love goes out to you. Hopefully there are some people around who are friends that can come and be with you this Christmas. Actually, some of the people we enjoy the most are our campus pastors, yeah. Our church family. Don't we love those guys?
We do.
We get together every week. We have so much fun. We have barbecues, lots of laughs. It's just a wonderful family. Wouldn't it be great if they were just here right now joining us for Christmas Day?
It would. Shall we have a go?
Let's try and get them, shall we? Here we go, here we go. One, two, three. Yay! Yay! Good to see you guys.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We love you guys. Oh, you make our lives seem so happy. And we have so much fun with you guys during the year. Why don't you just introduce yourself, what campus you're from, and tell us something you're grateful for this Christmas. SJ.
Hello, SJ from City Campus. I am extremely grateful for this family, for my family at home, for our family, our church family, and our family overseas as well. But
awesome. Yeah. Simon.
Hi, everyone. I'm Simon from City Campus, and I am so thankful for starting new Christmas traditions.
Scotty and Lee.
Yeah, Scotty and Leanne. Merry Kadahimitsi, everybody, from us. We are grateful for...
Well, I'm grateful for my four boys, Scotty included.
Clark.
Yeah, hi everyone, I'm from Beach Campus and just super grateful this year for our wider church family as well as our wider Vineyard movement as well. So woo-hoo! Wish you all have a Merry Christmas.
Cool. And Timmy.
Yeah, hey, I'm Timmy from West. I'm just really excited about holidays and thankful for that this year and my four beautiful girls as well. I'm really thankful for them.
I'm excited about your hat.
Yeah. It's a fashion statement. Actually, talking about fashion statements.
Brendan and Amy from Ashburton.
And we are so grateful for all the team that have supported us as we've planted Ashburton this year. Well
done. Wow, it is so good to get together as whānau and we've had a great year together. It certainly has been good. But we want to just relax and, you know, one of those things that happens on Christmas Day, you feel like you're relaxing.
Once you've eaten, there's too
many people around and you just wish that you could just click your fingers and everybody would be gone. What do you reckon? Yeah. What do you reckon? Here we go, let's try it.
Well, if only it was that easy. I know.
What are you doing here?
How come you're
still
here?
It didn't work, did it? We'll do it again. We'll do it again.
No, it's not working.
Oh my goodness. Some guests don't get the message. Oh, we do love those guys.